Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and welcome back to the Diz Quiz. As always, I'm your host, Tommy T, here with the conclusion of this episode with our friends from across the pond, Chat Disney. We're going to get into that in just a minute, but before we do, if you're enjoying the Diz Quiz, I really hope you are. I'd love to hear a comment from you, hear a post on our Facebook page, on our Instagram post, on our tweet me, whatever really works for you. I'd just love to hear from you if you're out there. We're getting to the end of the year here, and it's been a great few weeks of Diz Quiz content, and I hope you're enjoying it. I hope you're enjoying the new shows, the old show here. It's been really fun putting them all together, so I just love to hear from the audience. That's my kind of call to action for this week as we head towards the end of 2019. We're going to get into the show in just a second, but before we do, let me just recap the score for you. And if you haven't watched part one, be sure to go do that because the link is in the description, and I'm going to spoil it for you in just a second. So you ready to watch part one? All right, so right now, Mercedes is ahead 9-7, but like I always say, and I will continue to say, in part two, points are doubled, scores change quickly, a lot can happen here in our final two categories. So let's get into it and rejoin Mercedes and Tash. And we are back with Mercedes and Tash here for part two of our Disney trivia show. Before we get into these part two questions, let's let them introduce themselves one more time. And we'll start with Tash here. You can tell us about you guys and about Chat Disney.
So I'm Tash. Mercedes and I have been friends for a very long time. We started our Chat Disney podcast earlier this year. So yeah, it's going really well so far. We're having a lot of fun with it. We just decided to basically put all of our knowledge and our passion together. We talk about many different things, from our top attractions, top parks, top films, top songs. We also like to talk about our worst things with Disney as well. So they're always great episodes to listen to. So yeah, if you're looking for a new podcast, please do give us a follow and a listen.
Awesome, for sure. And then Mercedes, anything to add about yourself and your take on the podcast?
Yeah, so Tash and I have been friends for, I think it's like 17 years or something now, which is quite scary because that kind of reminds me of how old we're getting as well.
I know.
But yeah, Tash basically wrapped it up perfectly. Chat Disney is the number one destination for just general chit-chat of all things Disney. We like to cover a very broad spectrum of bits and pieces, so definitely give us a listen.
For sure. All right, so we're going to head into our round two questions here. Remember, so these are worth 2 points each. There's no more, 50-50. You'll just have to come up with the answer. And then if you get the question wrong, the other person can answer it for those points. So this next category, I think, is going to throw you two for a little bit of a loop when I tell you what it is. Because to pull the curtain back a little bit, this episode won't drop until December because I've got a bunch that I put in the can. I'm putting them out once a month. So it's August right now here. It's hot where I am. It's 90 degrees. But when this comes out, it'll be chilly. We'll all be thinking about the holiday season. And so this category is about Disney Christmas movies.
Oh, God.
So a little bit of Christmas in August for us, but you at home, it's Christmas time. I hope this is a fun little way to get into the Christmas spirit here in December. Hello from August. You'll be jealous that I'm here sweating probably by the time it's, deep in the low degrees. But so this is a wide ranging category of Christmassy things, both live action and animation and shorts and all kinds of stuff is kind of be mentioned here. So it's just a hodgepodge of Disney Christmas kind of stuff. So so Tash is now trailing this time around. So she will go first here in Disney Christmas movie trivia. Are you ready?
No. Yeah.
All right. Well, let's start off with this one. That's a pretty broad question. So what classic Christmas story has Disney released at least three different versions of? So they've told this story in movie form three different times with, they've released movies with this, it's pretty much the same premise and everything. It's a classic Christmas story. Do you know which one I'm talking about here?
Oh God, I can think of two, but
so if you can get me two, if you can prove to me that there's one that could fall into the answer here, but
I'm thinking of the Nutcracker. but I don't know how many versions they've done of that. I can only think of one, or maybe two. This is hard.
I want to give you a tiny hint here, just because this is so broad, but it is the story was written by a British gentleman, so that might steer you. I think Mercedes knows this one though, so I'm gonna stop giving hints here. But it is a British author that
Is
wrote
it
this.
the other one, oh my God, what's it called? The Charles Dickens one, the Christmas Carol.
You got it.
I
Sorry,
was thinking it's one of
Mercedes,
those.
I owe you a hint.
That's okay. That's quite all right. I studied literature at university as well. Sorry, Ben.
So you got a
I
leg
knew
up there.
it had to be one of those two because I was like, what are other classic Christmas tales? But yeah.
Right. Yeah, they might have done a few. Yeah, the Nutcracker has been covered in some way at least two times, like you
Yeah, I
said,
can only
maybe
think of
three.
one kind of short that used to be on the when they used to do the House of Mouse
Right.
version of the one.
And they've
But
done the Nutcracker and the Four Realms
yeah,
as
which
well.
that came out
That's
last
it, yeah,
year.
that was another one
Yeah.
that came last year,
And then
I
you
think.
could count, I mean, Fantasia uses the Nutcracker music even though it's not Christmas.
Oh
So
yeah, true.
that I might have, had to give to you anyway. But you got to A Christmas Carol. We've just to name off the three versions that I know of, off the top of my head would be Mickey's Christmas Carol, then they released A Muppet Christmas Carol, which is one of my favorites, and then they did the weird Jim Carrey one a few years ago, the
Yeah, I forgot
CGI,
about
which I never saw it, but it was kind of scary looking to me.
that one.
Maybe I'll check it out at some point. Okay, so this one is a bit of a deep cut, Tash, but the question is, what is the subtitle of the Santa Claus 3?
Oh my God. I've never even seen any of the Santa Claus
Oh,
movies,
man.
I think, so I don't think I could even hazard a guess with this one. I've absolutely got no idea.
Does Mercedes know?
I feel like I do. I think it's the one where all of the different, like Easter Bunny, and is it something to do with like Jack Frost?
Jack Frost is a character in it, I believe, played by Martin Short.
Okay.
So
Oh,
here I'm going to
man.
give you the. This isn't really a hint, but I'll tell you that the second one is called the Mrs. Claus. I don't know if that helps you at all.
No.
Yeah,
Yeah, I remember the second one.
Baby Claus?
Yeah. The
No, I
Santa
missed it.
Claus, the Mrs. Claus. No, I don't know.
So it is actually called the Santa Claus 3, The Escape Clause.
Oh,
That's one of those ones you just kind of know it or you don't. But so no points there. So the next one we're sticking with Tash on this one. So this is might be a little bit easier to figure out. So what 90s Disney animated film got a Christmas-themed sequel that of course went direct to video, but one of the classic Disney movies got its own Christmas version or Christmas sequel, I should say.
Beauty and the Beast.
You got it. It was Beauty and the Beast, The Enchanted Christmas. Came out there back. I did a category earlier in the in this season that was just all direct-to-video sequels, whether or not the movies got it, and a lot of them did from that era. So Beauty and the Beast
Right.
was one of them. All right, so I asked that Christmas Carol question first because there's a few questions here about some iterations of A Christmas Carol done by Disney. This one's about Mickey's Christmas Carol, and it sounds like you're not super familiar with this story, or maybe you don't remember it as well, but there is a character that is the ghost of Jacob Marley, who's an important character in A Christmas Carol. Do you know which Disney character portrayed him in a Mickey's Christmas Carol?
It's
It
Goofy.
is Goofy. Okay, so you got it.
Yeah,
You're on
I do
board here.
actually love that version,
Yeah,
which I
that's
think
a great one.
Koi, she's pretending she doesn't know.
There you go. I love the Muppet one, which they brought in Statler and Waldorf to be.
Yeah, I
So
know. Those two
it's
different.
Jacob Marley and his brother Robert Marley, which when you realize that it's Bob Marley, which I
Oh
love. It took me a couple of viewings to get that. It's like, oh wait a minute, his name's Bob Marley. They just
I've never realized that either.
I know, it's such a funny it's the thing that's Muppet humor, you don't realize it the first couple times, then one day it just clicks.
That's pretty
All right, so the last one for you here, Tash, is gonna be in The Nightmare Before Christmas, what job does Jack give to Sally to prepare for Christmas?
Oh, I feel like Mercedes will definitely know this. What job does he give to Sally?
Yep, so he's giving all the townspeople different jobs, you know, music and a couple, you know, decoration things, but Sally has a very special job.
Oh, I don't know. Oh, I'm going to completely guess because I've got no idea. Putting the star on top of the tree?
Good guess, but it is not the right one.
I don't know. Mercedes will 100%
Mercedes?
Know. I do know this. She has to make Jack's Sandy Claus outfit.
That is correct, because she's the sewer. You know, she's sewn together, so she sews the costume for him. All right, so Tash picked up 3 questions there, 6 more points, but Mercedes stole that last one, so you picked up a couple more here. So let's see how Mercedes does. It seems like she's doing well here. She knew a couple of those.
Then how about here.
All right, so do you know the name of the series of Disney shorts about Santa's team of elves that get homes ready for his arrival? I know that's a mouthful of a question, but so there's a bunch of short films about the elves that are sort of the SWAT team elves that go and
yeah, this rings a bell, but for some mm-hmm. reason it had something to do with that Arthur Christmas movie, but apparently not.
No. So no guess there?
No.
No? Does Tash know?
No.
No? I'm wondering now, I suddenly realize this, I wonder if it's because these might not have been played on TV in Europe. Is that possible? Because these were always on ABC in the US.
I've never heard of this before. I don't think I've seen any of these.
Yeah, so it's called Prep and Landing.
That rings a bell. I think it's on Disney Life, which is basically we have Disney Plus early in the UK. We
were You guys like the test, yeah.
Yeah. So that's we have awesome. Disney Life, and I think it might be on there.
That makes sense. Yeah. Yes, they were showing them for a few years on ABC, you know, the Disney owned network here in the US. And they're pretty fun. It's like, it's basically they go into the house before Santa and get everything like ready so he can come in and you know, efficiently get through the home, laying the presents. So it's sort of like SWAT team, secret agent style with elves. So that's kind of fun.
I've got so much to add to my Christmas watch.
Yeah, there you go. And they're like little, like, you know, TV episode length, 25-minute long things. Cool. So they're fun.
Nice.
Yeah. All right. So we're kicking it back again to the 90s. We've got a couple of 90s questions here. We'll see how you do with those. But back again to the Santa Claus franchise, actually. I got another Santa Claus because this is one of my personal favorite Christmas movies. Do you remember the name of the head elf in the Santa Claus, the original film?
I actually do. And I don't know if you can see, but I've got a little deer here.
Yep.
He has the same name.
Oh.
Bernard.
It is Bernard. My siblings and I just girl watched the movie, and it's just kind of one of those things for us. Is Bernard the elf was always such a funny character.
Yeah,
is that a coincidence, Mercedes, or did you name him after him?
It's a coincidence.
That's funny.
He's not named after him.
I would have been impressed if he was. I would have thought that was funny. All right, so back to A Muppet Christmas Carol. Actually, we talked about it a little bit before, but we didn't have a question about it. Who plays Ebenezer Scrooge in that version? The only human character.
Yeah, I believe that is Michael Caine.
You got it. And we're going to talk about him again a little bit later. If he's not, he should be. Another thing you got to look up.
I'm pretty sure he is. It sounds right.
Shouldn't be.
CBE means he's Sir. Yeah, right? Yep. So he is Sir Michael Caine, as he should be. All right, so back to Nightmare Before Christmas. There's only so many Christmas movies to pull from here, but Nightmare is the kind of classic one. And you actually already answered this question earlier by accident, but I got to give it to you again. So what does Jack mistakenly call Santa Claus throughout Nightmare Before Christmas?
Sandy Claus.
And then when he finally meets him, he says, "You don't have claws at all." All right, and one more 90s... question to round this thing out. What is the name of the 1998 Disney live-action Christmas film starring 90s heartthrob Jonathan Taylor Thomas?
Oh, I'm obsessed with Jonathan Taylor Thomas when we were teenagers. Do you remember that?
I do.
I'll Be Home for Christmas.
You got it. Mercedes knows her Christmas. All right, so let me do some quick tabulations here. So Mercedes picked up 10 more points, bring her up to 19, and Tash picked up just 6 for 13. So we've got a 6-point lead for Mercedes here, but in this last one, you know, that's nothing to make up. So like I said at the beginning of part one, that this last category was picked specifically for you guys because we're going to go through British actors who have appeared in Disney and Pixar movies. So I will, because like I said, this is my first British guest. I know there's such a great Disney community in the UK, and it's great to kind of tap into that a little bit here. And so I figure, why don't we theme this a little bit? So I will give the name of an actor. These are all like pretty famous actors from the UK. And you will tell me what Disney film they appeared in. Two of them, it's Disney or Pixar. Okay. Because I wanted to make sure that I got like some big names here. And two of them appeared in one of each, actually. So for those, I'll accept either one. Okay, so, and like I said, also, we'll go back and forth here to keep things kind of exciting as the scores go up. But we will start with Tash here in our Brits of Disney category. All right? So cool. The first one for Tash is Mr. Bean himself, Rowan Atkinson.
Mr. Bean himself, Rowan Atkinson, is Zazu in The Lion King.
You got it. All right. Next one for Mercedes is going to be Christian Bale. Who is Welsh, I believe.
Yes, he is. Yeah. I love this. This is like my little Disney
trivia.
This is
a good one. All right.
Yeah. Okay. So Thomas from Pocahontas.
He sure is.
I think I only found that out like a year and a half ago.
Yes.
And did I tell you?
I read it in like a weird Disney fact thing.
Yeah. Now, so we're talking about just voice acting here, by the way. I want to make that clear so you guys are right on the right track so far. But, of course, Christian Bale also appeared in Newsies as one of the leads in Newsies. Another his probably first Disney appearance, so that's kind of fun. All right, so back to Tash for this one. Timothy Dalton.
Oh, he's in – I know he's in – is it Toy Story 3? And he does the voice of –
You don't need to know the voice, but I want you to get this one because it's one of my favorite character names. I mean, you don't need to get the character. Sorry? Mr. Pricklepants.
Pricklepants, that's it.
And he did come back in Toy Story 4 for just a couple of lines.
Yeah.
But Toy Story 3 and 4 for Timothy Dalton, James Bond in the 80s, for those that might not be familiar. Okay, so next one goes back to Mercedes with Emma Thompson.
Yes, I remember. Oh, that stumped me for a while. It's a really good one. She is the queen in Brave.
She is. And this is also one of the ones that is in two. So she is the queen in Brave. She's the mother, and that's one her bigger role probably. But then she's also one of the crew members in Treasure Planet. She is Captain Amelia.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah. I haven't watched that movie in a while. It's a good movie. I haven't seen it in a little while. And it was kind of fun to come across that one.
And then live action as well. She is Mrs. Potts, isn't she? In the new one.
Yep. Yeah. And then she was Save Mr. Banks. She was P.L. Travers. Yeah. So yeah, she's definitely a Disney
around
in the Disney family. Yep. All right. So we talked about this actor a little bit while ago, Tash. But Sir Michael Caine, what movie does he provide a voice for?
Oh,
this is good a tough. Question. This is a tough one.
I feel like as soon as you say, I'm going to be like, of course, because he's got such a distinguishable voice.
Yeah.
Oh God, this is hard. Okay. Mercedes, do you know? You do.
You hate the movie. You hate.
Do I?
Yeah.
I don't like this movie either, but
Dan likes the movie, but you hate it.
Is it the Good Dinosaur?
It's
damn.
Not the Good Dinosaur.
I don't know, and I feel like as soon as you say, I'm going to kick myself, but no, I can't think.
Mercedes?
Cars 2.
It is Cars 2. Finn MacMissile.
Well done. Well done.
Good stuff. All right, sticking with Mercedes for your question here is going to be Minnie Driver.
Oh, yes, I know this. she plays Jane in Tarzan.
Got it.
Daddy, I lost my boot. I love that.
Yeah, she's great in that.
She is.
All right, back over to Tash for everybody's in love with this guy, Idris Elba.
Oh, he is in Zootropolis, Zootopia, whatever you want to call it, and he is, what's his name?
I wouldn't have known his name, actually. I have it written here.
What's his name?
And this is also one of the twofers. He's in a Pixar movie as well. Do you guys know which Pixar movie he's in?
Which Pixar movie?
Is he in a Toy Story?
Not Toy Story.
Ooh.
I don't know the Pixar one.
So he's Chief Bogo is his name in
Chief Bogo, that's it.
In Zootopia. Is it called Zootropolis in
It in is. It is. Because Tash lived in China at the time, she calls it Zootopia. But I also call it Zootopia because it was announced as Zootopia. Right. But in the EU, across the whole of Europe, it's Zootropolis. It's to do with intellectual property and boring.
Oh, wow. That makes sense.
Yeah.
Interesting.
So,
I learned something today. Yeah, there you go.
Thank you.
What Pixar film?
So he is in Finding Dory, and he is Fluke, the what animal is that? Is it a seal or a sea lion? Yeah.
Yes.
Or I'm gonna do my British accent, but I just love his get off.
Yes.
That was very good.
Oh, thank you.
That was. Yeah.
I watch a lot of British television, so I guess I pick it. okay, so that one started with Tash, right? Yeah. So this is over to Mercedes for Helen Mirren.
Oh, Helen Mirren.
This is a tough one.
Name, but she is the professor in Monsters University.
Wow, you got it. I would not have known this one because I like that movie, but I've only seen it once, so it didn't really make a huge impression on me. But the character's name is Dean Hardscrabble.
Yeah.
In Monsters U. All right, so back to Tash for Angela Lansbury.
Angela Lansbury is Mrs. Potts.
That's the easy one of the bunch. Yeah. But I had to put it in because it's the, you know, it's probably the most classic of all these performances. Yep. And I think Mercedes has clinched it by now, but let's see if you know Craig Ferguson, where he appears. Now,
Craig Ferguson?
Yeah, this is another tough one. Where's he from? Because I'm realizing he's not from Ireland, is he?
I don't know who he is.
Oh, you don't know who he is?
I know the name, but I can't think who he is.
Oh, that's funny. You know, he's Scottish. So he's Scottish. That's UK, right? So that counts.
Yeah.
It's funny. You know, he's probably more famous in the US than in the UK. He's probably not all that famous in the UK, but he was in a show here, The Drew Carey Show. You know, do you know Drew Carey, the actor? Oh, look him up. So he had a sitcom like in the late 90s in the U.S. But then Craig Ferguson went on to have a late night talk show
U.S.
for
many
years.
I know the name, but I can't think who he is.
Yeah, he was on right after David Letterman on CBS for many years here in the U.S. But he's a Scottish actor, and he provides the voice for Owl. Owl in the new Winnie the Pooh.
Oh, nice.
That's funny. I guess he came over to England from England or from the UK to the US fairly early in his career and got. I never knew this. I never realized this. I always figured he had a UK career before coming to the US. But I guess one of those rare Brits that got their got famous here first. So no points for that one. But let me just do a final count up just to make sure what our final score is here. So Mercedes picked up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more questions there for a score of 29. And Tash picked up 1, 2, 3, 4 for a score of 21. So Mercedes takes this one home, but I think we did a great job overall. I like when it's, you know, this is the perfect kind of show where most of them you got right, a few of them tripped you up. I'm good with that. I hope you guys had fun as well.
Yeah, so much fun.
We enjoyed it.
Yeah.
Well, thanks so much. Why don't you give one more plug for your social feeds and your podcast and your Disney ongoings on the webs?
So we release our podcast, Chat Disney, every Monday morning. You can find us on Instagram at Chat Disney or Twitter at Chat Disney UK. And that's where you can kind of keep up to date with all of our goings on and know what's coming up. So yeah, please do give us a like and a follow.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much again.
Thank you for having us.
We had a blast.
All right. That will do it. Thank you so much, guys.
Thank you.
This is really fun.
Well, that does it here for the Diz Quiz. I hope you enjoyed this episode and all the other shows here we're doing on the Diz Quiz little network here we got going with the new shows. It's been a lot of fun to put them all together, and I think this will be the last Diz Quiz show for 2019, but we got a couple more to come after the new year. I hope you'll stick around for those, and then we'll see what happens after that. But if you're enjoying the Diz Quiz, subscribing and liking, sharing, all of that kind of stuff that gets thrown around all the time, and it gets thrown around, it is a cliche because it helps, it makes a difference, and it really means a lot. So happy new year, happy holidays, Merry Christmas, whatever you celebrate, I hope it's great and spent with family and friends and loved ones. And until next year, I've been Tommy T, this has been the Diz Quiz, and we will see you real soon. Bye-bye.